Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to tell how to use UI2. So I will explain two things. First is the syntax and second a program with the help of UI2, right? So here you can see a syntax is written. So it is having initialization, then it is having statement inside the loop and increment decrement, and then at end it is having condition, termination condition. So if this condition is true, then loop will repeat. If condition is false, then loop rotation will be stopped. So first of all, this initialization takes place, then this statement will be executed, then this increment decrement will be performed, then this condition will be checked. If condition is true, then it will again come to statement execution, and this way it iterates. When this condition is false, then it is terminated. So do while is basically a bottom tested loop, so it executes at least once, right? So now there is a requirement, like if condition is true or false at the first time, then also it will execute at least once. So no matter your condition is true or false, it will execute at least once. So what is the benefit of this? Because if first time condition is false, then unnecessarily it is executing at least once. So we don't want to do that. So now, right now this is drawback. I am going to convert this drawback into advantage of do while, right? So I am going to implement a program in front of you. So the requirement of program is we need to read n numbers from user and we need to calculate their sum, right? And we will read numbers as per user's choice. So if user say like I want to add a number, then that number will be entered and will be added, otherwise not. So here our requirement is user will provide at least one number, and after that he will provide his choice whether he want to add another number or not. So now I'm going to implement that program in front of you. So here you can see I declared three variables, n to read number, s to calculate sum, and ch is for choice. Then before starting printf, I am writing do, and I will write printf inside it because I want to repeat that. So it will display the message enter a number, and after this we need to use semicolon. And here you can see the entered number will be stored inside the n variable, right? Now we can add this into s. So n will be added to s and the result will be stored inside s. After this addition, again I am writing a printf. So it will display do you want to add more number, right? So press 1 for yes and 0 for no. So this printf will be displayed. So if you want to add more numbers, you need to press 1, that will be equivalent to yes. Otherwise you can press 0, that is equivalent to no. Now we can read this. And I am going to read this choice into ch variable, and then I am going to apply while. So this is our condition. Inside while I am writing ch double equals to 1. So if user provided 1 into the ch variable, then this condition will be true. If this condition is true, then only your loop will repeat. Now let's check how it will execute. So execution begins from here, like 2, then curly braces, then printf. So this printf will print enter a number on screen. So user will enter a number in n. So let's say user entered 5 inside n. So that number will be added into s. So So S will be having 5. Then this message will be printed. So let's say user entered 1. So value of CH will be 1. Then this condition will be checked. So this condition is true. So again control will transfer to here. So again this message enter a number will be displayed. So user has to enter new value inside n. So let's say this time user entered 10. So now s plus n. So current value of s is 5. So 5 will be added into 10. So new number will become 15. Now again this printf will print on screen. So suppose this time user entered 0. User don't want to add more numbers, right? So check this condition, ch double equals to 1. So it is false. It means this loop execution will be terminated now. So no more input and no more addition will be done. So finally our sum is 15. So after this while, you can write a simple printf statement, and this printf will print the sum that is available inside the s variable, and then you can close the main function. So I hope you understood how I implemented this program with the help of do while. So here I hope you understood, whenever we execute the program, so at least first time user will provide a number, and then after providing that first number, on providing second number, so before providing second number, user need to select a particular choice. So here you can see choices are 2, 1 or 0. So if user pick 1, then loop will repeat, otherwise loop will be terminated. So this way I hope you understood how we can use drawback of do while, that is it execute at least once whether the condition is true or false. So in some scenarios you require this situation, like first time forcefully you want to execute the statements, and then after first execution, second execution depends upon the user's choice. So in those scenarios you can implement the do while loop. So I think this is the advantage of do while. So wherever you want to execute your statements at least one, and then the choice will depend upon the user, then you can implement do while loop. Otherwise we can implement for and while loop. Those are available in C program. So I hope you understood the explanation which I presented in this video in front of you. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel and go to playlist. So there are various programming related videos are available. So I uploaded more than 1000 videos. You can watch them and you can understand how programming can be implemented. So I uploaded videos related to C, C++, Java, PHP, Python, Salesforce, etc. So do follow those videos and learn programming. Thank you for watching this video.